Namaskar and good morning. The Q2 FY21 result season has started very well, especially with the Tata Consultancy Services. I don't say the results are very great, but they are much better than Q1 results. As you all know, Tata Consultancy Services is number one software service provider in India and very famous across the world. The management consists of N. Chandrasekaran, Chairman, Rajesh Gopinathan, Managing Director and CEO, N. G. Subramaniam, Executive Director and Chief Operating Officer. The revenue for Q1 is 40,135 crores, which is 4.7% more quarter on quarter and 3% more year on year. The net income, according to the press release, is 8,433 crores, which is plus 20.3% quarter on quarter and 4.9% year on year. Operating profit margin expands 2.2% year on year to 26.2%. Net margin stands at 21%. The net cash from operations is ₹10,618 crores. 10,618 crores net cash, and it is 125.9% of the net income. The consolidated headcount, number of employees, is 4,53,540. The net addition during the quarter is 9,864. Remember, it is a COVID quarter. Even in COVID quarter, TCS has recruited 9,864 additional net. Women consist of 36.4% of the total headcount. Of these employees, 3,52,000 plus are trained in new technologies. 4,27,000 plus are trained in agile methods. Attrition rate has hit an all-time low of 8.9% LTM last 12 months. So, people are satisfied with the TCS. That's what the attrition rate, lowest attrition rate, indicates. It's one of the world's lowest, it seems. Now, if you look at the market price, it is around 2,826. Based on that market price and the quarterly EPS of latest Q2, the price earning is around 35.4. High, but TCS is always high. Volumes are 1,98,38,000, which means you can sell or buy in TCS very easily. 52-week price low is 1,504, 52-week high is 2,885. Now, the current price is very close to 52-week high. The company has declared an interim dividend of ₹12 per share. Face value of the share is ₹1. On that, ₹12 per share interim dividend. Now, earlier, for the year ended March 2020, TCS has declared an equity dividend of 7,800%, amounting to ₹78 for that year per share. Now, the TCS has approved, board has approved a buyback of 5,33,33,333 shares, 1.42% of the total equity at ₹3,000 per share. how were the historical prices. 3 years before, the price was 1,214. 2 years before, it was 2,059. 1 year before, 2,080. 3 months before, 2,269. Now, 2,825. So, with reference to 3 years before, that is 1,214, the increase is 132%. 2 years before, 3 years before, etc., hardly about 35% improvement. Now, if you look at the shareholding, 72.05% held by promoters, of that, 2.94% is pledged. A small percentage, no problem. TCS is one of the healthiest companies in India. One of the most healthiest companies. FIS hold about 16%, DIS hold 8.66%, other DIS hold another 1%, like that. So it is effectively using its capital to generate profit. That is, return on capital employed has been improving in the last 2 years. It is effectively using the shareholders funds also. Return on equity has also been improving in the last 2 years. Net profits, net profit margin are also increasing. The company has no debt. Very strong cash generating ability. Net profits have been increasing always, year to year. Sales are increasing, net profits are also increasing. Many brokerages are predicting strong momentum in prices. Now, if you look at clients, more than $100 million clients is up by two numbers. More than $20 million is up by three, and more than $5 million is up by 11 numbers year on year. Now, North America has improved by 3.6% year on year. Growth by market strategy. So, North America is their best. And growth is led by BFSI. BFSI improvement is plus 6.2% quarter on quarter. Retail has also improved by 8.8% quarter on quarter. So, growth is led by BFSI and retail. And also life sciences, 6.9% improvement. Now, from October 1st onwards, TCS is rolling out salary increases. Operating margin is industry leading at 26.2%. Very strong deal closures, as we have seen. Highest also, two numbers they have added. So the total value of the deal closures is $8.6 billion. Board has announced 16,000 crores buyback at rupees 3,000 per share. All markets have shown good sequential growth. North America has grown by 3.6%, UK has grown by 3.8%, continental Europe by 6.1%. Emerging markets also has grown, with India growing 20%, MEA by 8%, Latin America 5.5%, Asia Pacific 2.9%. So, TCS has grown very well during Q2. So, those who love IT sector, steady growth. I won't say that TCS will be a great multi-bagger, but it will grow. The order book is very strong, therefore next quarter, next quarter are also very assured growth. So take your pick. TCS is a great company. We wish it all the best in the days and years and quarters to come. So the Q2 result season has started very well with TCS. We will be having more and more very good numbers. That's what I hope. So I will come before you with another very good company very soon.